Off camera. Wait,
not the journal.
I gotta say something. Off camera.
All right, it's off.
Tyson, he said, "Hey, I'm concerned about how the community is gonna read you.
Yeah.
You've talked a lot about sex, and I feel like they're gonna think you're very shallow."
Right.
And it really stuck. I couldn't figure out why that was bothering me. And he wanted a different example for a deconditioned, overweight person of what like hits them in the face, like, "Oh shit, my fitness is failing me." And it wasn't hitting me. I'm like, how obese is the American community? 50% are obese?
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Then 50% of the American population, the only time they're experiencing a peaked heart rate is sex.
Right.
They're avoiding any activity at all. So
right.
He's like, you know, when I go hiking up a mountain,
right.
Fat people are not hiking up no
right,
mountains.
Right, right.
They're sitting on the couch. They're not getting any
right.
spiked heart rate. So
right.
Fat people, the only activity they're going to see is when they're masturbating or they're fucking.
Right.
So it's not like I'm shallow. It's just I'm thinking as a fat person, when I didn't sweat or peak heart rate for 3 straight months.
I think it's more that Tyson's more like a monk and he doesn't realize you're just a normal dude.
Have you been CrossFitting? Tell me about your fitness and your health.
What's stopping you from being the guy that goes home and changes your life?
It's time for him to like reinvent himself again.
Officially divorced.
Hi, Samara.
Hi, how are you?
She has zero say in your involvement with Tinder.
Is Tinder that easy?
Have you ate anything or had anything to drink that you didn't send me?
I took a sip of my mom's Coke.
Holy shit.
Have you talked to Anise in the last 48 hours?
I sent her a picture of my new girlfriend. Do you know when we're done with this, people are gonna hate me?
No, don't listen to Tyson. Are you kidding? People are gonna look up to you. People are gonna be like, "Oh my God, I'm gonna leave my wife, get an RV, get on Tinder, and
CrossFit, it has been literally a fountain of youth. I want to go on some dates here, right?
Of course, yeah.
The Santa Cruz ladies are tougher.
Why?
I don't know. They're not enjoying my profile, apparently.
Oh, that's too much, man.
What do you mean that's too much?
That's like an essay.
That's too much.
Because all girls say, "What's up with all these D-bags?" So I put, "You are safe. No D-bags here. Good? Good." Right? I'm not a D-bag, I'm a nice dude, right? What's up, bro? Meatloaf Mondays, bro. I'm very adventurous, I follow the heart, I believe in love, I cuddle, I'm funny sometimes, I talk to people for a living, my life is on the go, looking for someone to rock the world with. Not interested in endless chats, let's meet and get to know each other. 21-year-old daughter, the best thing I've ever done in pictures.
How many matches so far?
You can't show other
people. You can't
people.
Be selective.
1, 2, 3, 4. There's 6 matches in here, but I've probably unmatched like 10.
For science, you pay for premium, then expensive.
I.
For next one, yeah. It's only $8 a month.
I do pay the.
I'm gonna hijack this conversation.
Are you recording?
Yep, okay. I think. Nutrition up to this point, all we've done is establish 3 simple rules and you've crushed it.
Improve the quality of his food, learn the importance of balancing meals, and also meal timing to keep the metabolism cranking the way we want with those good balanced real food meals. And he crushed it, 18 pounds this first month, and the next step is to talk about adding in some accuracy and precision to how much, which is the zone. Yeah. And it works really, really, really well.
Yeah. Is he gonna use a scale?
Yeah, we're gonna talk about weighing and measuring and full on send him down the road of zoning.
Anyone who wants to lose weight should just come here and sit at the table with you.
Yeah. He
right?
I was just about to eat. My text message is like, hey. And I was like, what the fuck? Why is he sending me 6 hays? And he's like, don't eat. And I look up, he's like, don't eat yet. For the last month and a half-ish, I've been eyeballing my food, measurements, creating clean habits, getting rid of bad habits, creating new good habits, right? And so I've been asking him, well, I don't know how much I'm eating, if it's enough. So he just surprise attacked me to see, and I knew my spinach was a little light today, but I was just going through a container, so damn it.
You've started to ask the natural question, which is, okay, now I'm eating cleaner. I've got the timing down and I've got meal balancing, you know, figured out now. How much should I eat? It's like the natural next question that you've asked me a couple times. And I keep pumping the brakes and I'm like, we'll get to it.
Yeah.
We're gonna talk about it. That's all the zone is. The zone is being precise about how much you should be eating at each of these well-balanced meals that you're having. The CrossFit Bible, nutrition Bible, has been for over a decade now. CrossFit Journal 21. I think you pulled it up earlier. I think it published in 2004, right?
Yeah, May 2004.
Yeah, I mean, it's been out there for a long time. So this is just an updated version of Journal 21. This is the nutrition Bible for CrossFitters.
Okay.
So zone, 40-30-30. 40% carbohydrate, 30% protein, 30% fat. The zone has its own system of measurement. It's a block. You've heard people talk about that in the gym, right? You're allotted a certain number of blocks in a day, and then you divvy those blocks up into meals, however works best for the individual. For me, I'm a 16 blocker, and I like to keep my meals kind of the same size. There's a lot of people that will do like little zone, you know, one block snacks, and again, we'll dig into this and I'll explain exactly what this means, but they'll do like one or two block snacks. I don't like that. I do four block meals and just evenly timed throughout the day. And for me, that's worked really, really well. So I'm gonna encourage you to do the same thing. But it says right here, what is a block? A block is 9 grams of carbohydrate, 7 grams of protein, and 1.5 grams of fat.
So the nuts is 1.5 grams.
That's what we're gonna go with.
And you're saying this, you're eyeballing, that's too much.
I'm saying that's gonna be a little much.
I think where we need to start you at is 18 blocks. And again, we could look at the way, you know, Journal 21 outlines how to identify like how many blocks a person should be on.
Okay.
And we could factor in all these different things. And it might say something different if we were to do that. Again, I'm just gonna go off of my experience, and 18 blocks is where I think you need to be for now.
Nuts and nut butters, 3 grams?
That's per block.
Oh, okay, so that's three. If I'm doing a five, that's 15. 15 grams.
Yeah.
We're gonna keep it so like insanely basic. Like all you're gonna do is you're gonna look at a food and say, okay, that is a protein or that is a carb, and then you're just gonna do the math.
Right.
Right? So your picture of your breakfast this morning was eggs, spinach, some sweet potato, and some almonds.
Yeah.
So let's just break down that meal. The egg is your
protein.
And your carbs are
spinach and sweet potato.
And your fat is
almond.
Awesome. Just that. That's how basic you need to keep it.
So zero that out. You wanna zero that?
Okay. Come on, baby. 9 grams is carb. 7 yep. grams is protein. So to figure out my carb, it's 7. And 1.5 is fat.
Yep.
So to figure out a 5-block meal is for carb is 9 times 5. For protein, 7 times 5. And for fat is 1.5 times 5.
Five. Exactly.
Under. Oh, bitches.
That's 120.
That's what I said. Spinach is going to F me up, right?
Zero it.
Oh.
Now zero.
Oh, I got it.
Now throw on. What's, did you find? What, your
spinach is 252. And you're saying times it by five?
This is what I was.
Do the math. What's the number?
That's what I'm saying. So 252.
Oh, I'm so scared. I knew I was light on spinach.
Yeah, it's not even a half a block. See, that's what I was telling you.
What the fudge? Dude, I put a big mountain of spinach in that bitch.
So that's 90 grams of spinach. It's not even a...
It's not even a block?
It's not, well, it's like not even
son of a cockroach.
It's not even half a block.
Not even half a block?
Is there a certain meal where it's like, I think I can eat a little bit more at this meal than... Like I like a heavier breakfast and kind of a lighter.
I like a lighter dinner.
Okay, so lighter. So we'll just kind of we'll
yeah,
just
I like
load
to
some
start
of that stuff
heavier, through. Taper down. I feel like I'd do better if I have less in my belly.
Let's do a 5 block breakfast and lunch, and then we're gonna do a 4 block, call it mid morning or mid afternoon snack. Mm-hmm. It depends on how your day breaks up, and then we'll do a 4 block dinner.
Not yet, but I thought the spinach itself was pretty good. And he's like, you gotta add some sweet potato. I cut a sweet potato in half because I thought it was too much.
What did you do this weekend?
Oh my God, I swear to God.
What?
Why are you asking?
We're asking like, should we have
dinner? We have company.
Oh.
We have women here.
What?
You can't talk about what you did this weekend with women here?
Well,
that's a good weekend.
I had a quote friend visit. I think Tyson wants to finish the food. Okay, let's save my sweet potato, because I'm hungry.
When you were downstairs today talking on the phone, who were you talking to?
Just so you can kind of see like what the process is.
So this is
like.
About half of what he should be eating.
Gary's gonna do 18 blocks.
All right.
So he's gonna lose weight on that?
Yeah. Oh yeah. He's gonna continue to melt. Like he has
I feel like there's a lot of food.
Yeah. It is a lot of food. Look how skinny his neck is. If it gets any skinnier, it's not going to hold that big old head of his. Who were you talking to on the phone today when you were pacing back and forth in front of
Corey.
Me? Corey
Allen.
So it was a work call?
Mm-hmm.
Last time you were down there, it wasn't a work call.
Yeah, no, this time it was a work call.
Oh. Did you, you know what I thought you were doing? I thought you were telling your ex-wife about your weekend.
No, we kind of kept the personals. We haven't really talked.
Does she know that you had a visitor this weekend?
No. We talked today because I think she stole my steak knives.
Stole is a little strong.
She was supposed to evenly distribute the kitchenwares, and she didn't leave me with any cutlery.
And you just realized that? And you just realized that?
Well, I've been using another knife, and I was going through a drawer, and I noticed the whole steak knife set was gone. And I messaged her, where are the steak knife? She goes, I wasn't breaking up a set. I said, well, why do you get the set? I put a smiley face, so I was half joking. But anyways, we did speak on that, and we did not talk about my weekend.
So last week there was a little bit of like emotional, like just like, man, I'm all alone.
Yes.
And then this weekend, you had company.
Helps.
You did? Is she still, if I went to your camper now, is she there?
No, she left last night.
What? How long did she stay for?
She got in Friday night, stayed for 39 hours.
Were you ever like, oh, this is too much?
No, we had a good weekend.
All 39 hours.
That we were awake, yeah. We went and saw some butterflies.
Oh yeah, I saw that on your Instagram.
We went and saw the butterflies, we went and carved some pumpkins. And we just hung out. she's my special friend, and she didn't really want to be part of the project, and she kind of understood that, like, it was kind of an open, casual, we enjoy each other company sort of situation, and so I was...
It's a cuddle relationship.
Yeah, I wasn't 100% sure...
It's a relationship for cuddling.
If it was wanted to be part of the project, like...
Right.
I don't know where it's going. We enjoy each other's company, but again, like if I were to stay up here...
Did she drop any lines on you while she was here? Like, I could really get used to this camper living.
No, she didn't. And it's funny, we were talking about, so this whole time I've been very strong, haven't cheated, but with this whole Halloween business, walking around these stores, I feel like food, cheap food, has gotten 10 times bigger than a month ago. Like, if you were to picture my life into a cartoon, a month ago it was like normal size. Oh, who needs that? And it's like slowly gotten bigger. And now it's like flashing and like...
You feel like there's just candy corns everywhere.
Yeah, they're just, the aisles are slowly getting into me and it feels like a horror story. Just one, it won't hurt.
Are you tempted?
I have been tempted. I'm telling you, I've been standing in the checkout and I'm like, what would one candy bar hurt? What would one candy bar hurt? And it's like, everywhere I look is candy. And I'm like, fuck.
Have you had any dreams where you're just like, you're just scooping ice cream into your mouth and you wake up and you're like, oh my God, I'm so glad that was a dream.
No, the stores, it's getting harder to walk in through. The frame of mind where I was at a month ago, like I would not ever cheat. Now I'm walking through the stores and I'm daydreaming about
having
moments. And I'm like, God, how long am I gonna go where I don't give in to any desires. Like, yeah. Tyson's pretty.
It sounds like this weekend you gave in to some desires. Do you think you're gonna tell your wife about your rendezvous?
It's a sore subject because she totally encouraged me not to have that relationship. She's like, it's dumb for you to get involved with somebody right when you're leaving. And I was like, well, I'm sorry, but it...
She was giving you relationship advice?
Yeah.
Nice.
So, I said, well, I don't know, and so I kind of really haven't wanted to mention it because she thought I should never have started that when I knew that I was leaving, and it's like, you don't really know if you're going to like somebody or not, so... But like I said, the last time I saw her, when I went down for that wedding, we did kind of like almost break it off. I was like, listen, I don't know. I don't know what I can give you in terms of...
This is the Kung Fu lady.
Yeah. And she's like, that's fine. I didn't ask for commitment from you. I enjoy spending time with you.
Has she posted any pictures of her and her new dude?
No, not yet.
Is that gonna hurt?
For some reason I'm feeling emotionally okay about it. I don't know why.
But you still take her back. You haven't crossed that line yet.
No, I don't know. I don't think so. Listen.
I think you want her for Halloween at least.
Yeah, for Halloween.
Tomorrow.
I joked with her if he hates Halloween, I'd take her back for Halloween every year.
Kinda joking, kinda real.
More real.
It's a Halloween season. It's her favorite holiday. Man, I said I wasn't gonna say that. Fuck, I hate you, Sebby. I was gonna try to keep her business out of it, but she just found out that he hates Halloween.
Ooh.
It's her favorite holiday.
That's where you creep in.
And she's like, oh, he hates Halloween. And I was like, shouldn't you have known that? She's like, well, he said he didn't celebrate Halloween, but I didn't realize like he disliked it. So I was like, hey, if he doesn't mind loaning you out, One week out of the year, I'll come in. I'll take you back for Halloween season. We'll go to the haunted house. She put LLL, ha ha ha. I do miss your Halloween spirit. She did say that. So we're getting along. We're getting along great.
Did she ask you how your workouts are going?
Yeah. She's interested. She's supportive.
She's just. Raise at work?
Yeah. She's just like a wife should be. If she
more
called.
Real.
Look, if she called me up right now and said, "I changed my mind. I fucked up." I don't know what my answer would be. I honestly don't know. Because we did have issues. There's some positivity to be gained with the idea that we are just friends and we no longer have to deal with the few issues that
let's say you're in a restaurant and you want to eat a candy bar, or you're in a store. Can you use this as your defense? Oh, I'm gonna fucking get in great shape and so she can just eat her heart out and then you don't eat the candy bar? Like, can she be motivation? Like sinister motivation?
No, I don't. I'm, there's nothing sinister about it. Here's what I want to know. I have thought about messaging her and saying, okay, so you've been there almost a month. She went there 2 more days. It'll be a month that she's been there. And I wanted to message her like a survey and be like, okay, if you were to grade your new life, would you
yes,
A plus?
Please do that. Yes, do that.
A minus?
Yes.
B plus? C plus? Like how?
I think you should drill down into some specifics. How often do you guys eat out? How often do you guys bone?
Yeah. It's not necessarily, it's more like her situation. There's a lot to be learned from expectations versus reality. Like your expectations of what your new life was going to be.
Right.
Versus what actually happened. How close is it?
Honeymoon period. It's also the honeymoon period.
Yeah. Like, how real is it? Not, that's just more.
Have you asked her in those 24 years she was apart from him if she ever cheated on you with him?
No. She had not. No. She had. No. I knew everything about her when she tried to
You've been reading her text messages for years. You would
no,
know.
Like, she would tell me. She'd be like, I looked for Dave on MySpace.
Oh.
And I sent him a message, and he never even got back to me. Oh. And so we had a conversation about how she reached out to him, and he ignored her.
So this has been going on forever.
Yeah, I've known he's out into the ether somewhere, and she's always been curious about him.
Oh, okay, yeah, no, I remember.
That's exciting, right? It's titillating. Like you got to take off someone's bra again. Was it a front bra or back bra?
Well, which day?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Different one was back.
First day was the back. Second day was no clip.
Just like a man.
And I was thinking about asking if you want to see a picture of her, but
yeah, naked.
I don't know if she wants to be on camera, but I'll show you.
Are you concerned about?
No.
Are you concerned about any venereal diseases?
I don't know why I can't keep quiet about people I'm talking to.
She's sultry.
Hi, hon. Are you off? Turn it.
Careful, that doesn't fall on the floor.
Are you off?
Yeah.
Come on. He's lying.
Hold on. Okay, so.
Okay. So my friend, she's awesome. She's sweet.
This is the one that you're having an extramarital affair with.
I'm not married anymore.
Oh yeah, sorry, you're divorced. Sorry, I keep forgetting.
So we hit it off, but on date one and two, we didn't talk about any politics. Not one politics. And what I found most interesting about her is we literally have very little in common. Like, I like dumb movies. She's like, I like, you know, art house movies. She's like, I was like, oh, do you watch this? No, I would never watch that. Music, just different spectrums as you can get. And to me, that's interesting. Okay, I can learn from you, you can learn from me. Well, then when we finally hooked up, like really hooked up, and it was done, she's like, oh shit.
Like you're laying in bed together?
Yeah. She's like, oh fuck. She's like, I gotta ask you a question. I'm like, what? Oh, because she turned on the TV and the news was on. And then there was like a light bulb went on and she's like, please, please, please tell me. Tell me you don't like Trump. I need to hear that. And I was like, he's an idiot. She's like, okay, you think he's an idiot? Yeah, of course he's an idiot. But then, later on...
But you did vote for him.
Yeah, but then later on, I was like, but we haven't really... I said, I do think he's an idiot, but... She's like, you didn't. Tell me you did. We had an amazing connection. And she, like, realized that... She's like, oh, this is too good to be true. Like, that was great.
Right.
And then she's like, oh no, she realized Trump supporters is a deal breaker, which we all know Trump is an idiot. But I was more of like the camp that just wanted to burn the system down. I thought both parties didn't like him, so maybe voting for him would be a good thing.
Think that it's best just to lie so you can keep getting laid? Like,
no,
like,
I didn't lie. I just wasn't expecting that thing. And then, so she's like, oh, good. And then I was like, okay, well, I basically said, so what are you saying? If I did like Trump, you would have never gone on a date with me? And she's like, probably not. Like, definitely. She said, I almost thought about putting no Trump people on our profile.
Oh.
Like, don't swipe right if you're a Trump supporter, which that is very common. Half the profiles on Tinder say, if you voted for Trump, swipe left.
Are there any that say, I only want to bone Trump supporters?
No, I haven't seen that. So, we continue to have discussions. Like this last weekend, we had a discussion, and it gets pretty, like her claws come out. And basically, she's like, he's just evil incarnate. And I'm like, couldn't he just more of just be a dummy? And
right.
Like, is his decisions really like to destroy the world, or he's just not that smart? And he's maybe picked some bad people. I don't know.
Right.
But I'm like, everything that's in the news about him can't all be right. I mean, it can't be the most horrible person ever. Imagine, like, maybe some little exaggeration is going on.
Does he always come up?
It pops up often, because it's very hard for her to justify the fact that she likes me and that I had...
You had that a relationship with Trump in the terms of checking a box.
She said, maybe it's just best that we don't talk about Trump. She says, I knowingly am probably a rebound relationship for you. And I mean, that's understandable. You've been married for 24 years. You're
just, she just wants you to rebound really hard. Give it to her harder. So when you live in a motorhome and the walls are thin, are you conscious that your neighbors might hear you?
I don't think about it.
You should.
I don't really think about it until it's perhaps too late. In fact, we don't want to get this out there, because if I have any company, I don't want them to not think about it. Anissa did think about it. Do you know what I had to do?
What? Put your hand on it?
No, I had to prove to her. I had to prove to Anissa when we first got the RV. I had to prove to her that it didn't shake that much. She had to stand outside, and I was on the bed, and I had to like do pretend thrusts against the bed so she could visually see that the RV did not shake.
When the RV's rocking, don't come and knock.
Yeah,
hey, do you think
before
you're
she could
get
trust
kicked out of your RV park because of this weekend?
No.
here.
Someone turned on the vacuum.
Like a warning, like a ladder.
A little warning.
Yeah, someone did turn on a vacuum cleaner to try to drown out the sound of you guys doing it.
Yesterday I heard this guy, the neighbor sweeping, and I was like, sweeping sounds kind of loud. And I didn't notice that my right window was open. And I was like, uh-oh. Oh my God. You're gonna get...
Or they were trying to partake by...
I won't lie, I was eyeing this one, then maybe I could at least stay close to these guys. You know, Dago, Leaf, Sevan, they're beasts, right? And I was like, I just want to stay close. You know, I'm scaling the dumbbell slightly, but then I was leading Sevi, and I'm like, I got this, I'm gonna get him! And then I really faded this last 200. And I felt this, I couldn't keep up. So close, getting closer, man.
I think you want the first 400.
Dago came in a few feet before me.
Yeah.
But I'm feeling good. Yesterday's run up the trail gave me a little confidence, I'll be honest. So I felt good about that. So compared to the last runs we did, that 400, 800, 12, 16 stuff. I was kind of smoked there, and I was like, I'm gonna push this one a little bit, see if I feel better, which I did until the very end.
Have you noticed any difference in your body as you run? Like, does your stomach also feel like it's moving less back and forth?
No, for sure. When we first started this, when I ran, it felt like, we talked about it before, it felt like the water suit, like sloshing around. You just feel everything. And now it feels more compact in my bones and I don't notice it when I'm running. It's a world of difference. Do you know that we weren't done with this?
Mm-hmm.
People are gonna hate me.
No, don't listen to Tyson, are you kidding? People are gonna look up to you. People are gonna be like, oh my God, I'm gonna leave my wife, get an RV, get on Tinder, and fuck like a man.
It's like, I could get laid after 6 weeks.
Yeah, but I'm fitter, and no Santa Cruz women are into my profile. Nobody's swiping. I think all men in the world need to stop for a second and go thank their wives, because I used to believe that it was at least equal. Working was comparable to being a domestic mom and cooking and cleaning. It is bullshit. Oh, man down. We have to take a picture.
True.
Bon appetito, Tyson.